Okay, let's start now. Okay, is my screen visible? Guys, let me know, is my screen visible to you all?
Yes, sir, your screen is visible.
Yeah, so only this screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine, my switch board is not visible. Okay, fine, that will be fine. Okay. Right, so I hope, guys, very good morning, and I hope you are all staying safe after a long time you are meeting. I'm just meeting with you all, and I hope your training sessions are going so good for the past few days, and we have kickstarted our training for this particular academic year. And every month like this, we'll be having four sessions of 4 days of complete training, and we would like, we will request you to make use of this opportunity. Okay, since we are using webinars, and because we expect more strength, that's why we cannot connect with GoToMeeting or another kind of thing. So here, Samarth sir, in webinar exam, can the students speak?
Sir, yes sir, students can request and speak, sir.
If they request, means what am I supposed to do, or is there anyone who's there to provide them any permission?
Yes sir, they have to, they must be allowed to speak, sir. I'll be taking care of that, sir.
No, you are going to attend the whole session. You have any other work?
Yes, sir. I'll attend the session, sir. No issues.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Obviously, I'll be attending, sir.
Okay, Samarth sir. Right. So so if anyone is interested to speak, but as I expect always, I expect everyone to interact in chat box, and also those who want to interact well in voice, you can also give a raise a request, so that Samarth sir will be giving you the permission for it. Okay. Right. So now, what you guys have learnt about linked list? So I'm just using this replet. What is linked list? Why do you want to go for linked list? First of all, see, already it has been taught, because I'm going to take some different programs from this linked list. So for that, I just want to brush up certain things. That's why I'm taking this. So don't have to worry about it. I'm taking the topics which faculty have already took. It's not like that. I just want to brush up certain things. That's why. Okay. Right. So fine. So what is linked list, and why we go for linked list in terms of, if we have arrays, then why we go for linked list? I need some answers. It can be either in chat boxes. It is alternate for arrays. Yeah, Dhanush, you are correct. It is alternate for arrays. Yes, then apart from that, it is alternate for arrays. And then only Dhanush is responding. What about others? Or sitting idle, or just giving attendance and just leaving out? Others? Okay, memory can be increased or decreased. Yes. Yeah, fine. So it is an alternate for array. Why it should be an alternate for array? Memory can be increased or decreased. In array, if I define a size of an array, why arrays are static? Because the size cannot be increased. Arrays are immutable. You cannot alter the size of that array. Okay, right. So once it is declared, you cannot insert any new element. Or insertion and deletion are the two operations that are very difficult in arrays. Why? Because in array, you will be given an contiguous memory locations. For example, you declare an array of size 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the 4 indexes will be filled. For example, in future, if I want to add some elements in between here, what I need to do is I need to push this index to the next available, to the next contiguous memory location. But the next memory after this, for example, let the addressing be like this. It starts from 1000, it's an integer array. Contiguous means every block will hold 4 bytes. 1004, 1008, and this last block is 1012. Okay, so if I want to insert an element in between, I should have the next 1016th block should be free. Got it? But it is, as array is declared, only these contiguous memory blocks will be allocated in the memory. But after this, you cannot find a memory, because the 1016th address block can be used by some other operation for your system or for some other application. You cannot predict. So if you want to insert an element, you need to switch your context. You need to check whether the element is already, the next contiguous elements are there or not, because we need to maintain that array principles of arrays, right? I mean, it's allocated in the contiguous memory locations or blocks. So that is why insertion and deletion is a tedious process. Lot of memory switching, context switching has to be done. Okay. And apart from that, another real time scenario: you take a cinema theater, you take a book a ticket in your for a movie. Okay. So take for example, if three people in another real time scenario, if three friends are going for a movie, so how they will fill? So for example, they look for three continuous seats, correct? One nearby, near. So that you can consider as an array. So if we have in the ticket booking system, if there are three contiguous blocks are available, then what we can do? We can fill this. This can be filled, booked, and this will be booked. Okay. Take for example, the number of free seats available are this particular one, and this one, and this one. These are the three blocks available. So you have three places to store your data, but you don't have those three places in the contiguous. It's not continuous, contiguous order. Okay, contiguous order. It is not in that order, as if it is in this array, but you have three blocks. So I can store that data. I can fill that seats. Okay, how? This is one block. This block should be referred. So for example, this is a person one, and person two will be linked. The person one is the data, and person two will be linked with person two and with its address, and person two will be linked with person three. Okay, likewise, you will form a link. Got it? Right? Because you guys are friends, you know where you are sitting and which row you are sitting. So this formation is called as linked list. Okay, right. Now coming to that, there are different ways of insertion. I think Giri sir and other training team faculties like Kitika, Gayatri, all the faculties would have taught you about the insertion. See, normally there are different levels of insertion you would have learned. Why I am telling this is very important. Insertion at the beginning, okay, or first. Next, insertion at end. That means tail or append. We will call this append function. Or insert at a given position, any position. Insert this particular node in the second position or third position, in between first and second, in between second and third, kind of thing. Okay, so these are the different levels of insertion. The same thing can be applied for deletion also. Got it? So insertion and deletion is easy because, for example, if I want to insert a new node, see, it is not like the contiguous memory address is important. See, another friend is going to come. They want to watch a movie along with you in the same theater. What he can supposed to do? If there is any other seats filled available here, he will be given that place, okay, to sit, for example. So that link already last node, he is the last one need to be added. So he will point to this address. He will point to an empty, because after this no one is going to come. So likewise, insertion is very easy. Got it? So if I want to, if he doesn't want to come later, this will be removed. This block will be removed. So this will point to an empty because no data is there. That's it, right? So this is the last one, only three members of this. That's why insertion and deletion are very, very, very important in linked list. So I have told you why insertion and deletion is not possible in array. How insertion and deletion is possible in linked list. Got it? Yes or no? Yes? Fine. And you cannot access in randomly because here it is based on what? Indexing. Okay, you can access the elements based on indexes. Whereas here it is based on address based accessing. Okay, so random access is not possible in linked list. Node by node traversal it is possible. Okay. Now, why? What is the data structure to create a linked list? See, to create an array, you have a specific array declaration. So what is the data structure to create a linked list? Why? What is the data structure you need to create a linked list? What is the storage structure? I am not getting about the data structure. What is the storage structure? Because the real problem, I am going to get into the real problem after some time only, because these inputs I have to give for you. What data structure you are going to create for an array? See, as we said, an array for a linked list, it must have a data and also it must have an address to point to the next node, to the next person. His seat number and its the person name. That is the node, right? So there are two different types. So the person name can be a string or a character array. or a character pointer. Okay, and the address can be what? An integer, correct? But I'm not going to point the integer and address value directly. What I'm going to point? I'm going to point the next node's address. So, for example, in C program, so the best language to learn data structure is C program. So, no other language comes near this C programming to learn data structure, because you will understand the fundamentals. Because pointers, the biggest concept called as pointers, are there in C. So that plays a major role in advanced learning. Got it? Fine. Now here, the best part here is, see what I'm telling you is, you have to point to an address, but address is not a raw integer. What I need to point, so who points to an address, in which data type points to an address? A pointer points to an address. So address of what? I'm not going to point to an address of another integer variable. I'm going to point an address of a node itself. So the type. So for example, in my data structure, I'm going to store, this is a node. Okay, I'm going to take a node. A node, you have, the node has a data path. One sec. The data part, for example, number one, and this has an address. Got it? Right? This has an address part. Understood? Right? So, to store an address, what it points? It points to another node. Okay? I'm not going to fetch the data. I'm going to point the address of another node. So, to store the data, what is this? So, it's like, let us take a simple node, an integer, int data. And address is what? Another node. Okay. And its pointer is next. This pointer points to the next node's address. What is the type here? This is of type node. Got it? This is of a struct. This is of type what? What is a different type? This is of type struct. Nuclear? Right. Why you are giving struct here? Why you are not using arrays or whatever it is? Just a minute. Struct is being used. Why? In C program, struct is a structure result storage type which is used to store data of different types. You can hold the structure with integer and also a pointer of a different node, and also you can store multiple different types of data, but a group of data can be stored in the structure. Whereas in array, only that of a similar type can be stored in an array. So that is why we are going to use structure. And another important thing, why we are not using union is, here, for storing this integer, I need an integer memory. For storing this address, I need that node's total memory. Node's total memory is what? So, for that node, it points to an address. So, that node structure itself will be initialized again, will be pointed again. Got it? So, in union, what happens? The highest memory, the data type which has the highest memory, that will be shared by other data types. That is the difference between using structures and union. So union cannot be applied for linked list, because that memory, for example, if I have a character data type instead of integer, okay, right, and this is a pointer, but if it creates memory for that pointer, but if I am going to store a float or double kind of things, the pointer, it points to an address, that address is an integer, but if my input is a double or long, it is more than that integer data type. Got it? Right? So unnecessary memory will be allocated, or sometimes you cannot have the proper memory structure in case of union. So that is why we are not going with union. So here we are going to enclose these things into a struct node. Okay, so this is the structure we are going to create. We are going to name this node. We have name. I think you have solved many programs. Many students have done excellently well. I must appreciate that discussion forum discussion. So many people have participated so well. So this is how it works. Got it? Now, I just want you to answer me, what is the difference between the head? You will be in your linked list code, what you will be creating? Struct node star root, or head you will be creating, correct? Always. What is this head? Is this a pointer or a node? This head is a pointer or a node. I'll raise a poll right now. Tell me, the head is a, I'm just locking this board, pointer or a node. Okay, now start giving your answers. Head is a pointer or a node? All of you, make it fast. Has everyone given the answer? Yeah, I just want the answers. See, let me publish the poll result, okay? 71%, so I think you can see the poll result, right? 71% of students has given it as head is a pointer, and 28% they have given it as head is a node. So my answer is, I will go with 71% of student. So why? What is that? So how it is getting stored? See, normally head is a pointer. I will tell you how linked list works in a basic way. You create a node. Okay, you create a node, multiple nodes are there. Okay, right. So now here, the data here is one, it points to the second node's address, and here, this is the value 2, this is the address part, it points to the third node. 3x is nothing but address. Third node address, this is node 3. And the third node's fourth node address, okay. And here the value is 4, and after this there is no node, so it points to the null. Now it gets linked like this. Okay, it gets linked like this. You clear? Right. Now here, why? If I want to create a node, why? What is the node role of that head pointer? See, head pointer is the major role. So I will ask you one simple question. How your data gets printed? You will start from, so you will, what you have considered is, there are some assumptions, like what we will consider is, this is the head pointer actually. Okay, this is a head node. Okay, I will, my pointer will jump from here, if I want to, so head of, next, head, this is a head node. What is the next part? 2x, so it will go to this, and from here, again, the pointer will be here. From here, I will jump here and I will print this data. From here, I will jump here and I will print this data. So, I will check that the current node of next is equal to null, means then I will terminate that. I will stop printing. So, it will print until while temp of next not equal to null. Got it? But actually, that is not the case. It won't work in that way. See, you created, created one syntax, right? Struct node star head. That head is a pointer. So, what is the role of a pointer in C program? A pointer, this is a pointer, this is not a node. Okay, why I am telling it as a pointer? Because when I consider as a node, for example, if my syntax is like this. So, struct node sum t equals, so I am just creating it equal to null, I am just initializing it. And then, that t equals, okay, I am just allocating dynamic memory allocation, struct node star malloc, okay, right? So I'll pass that malloc size of struct node, malloc size of struct node. So what happens here is, in this line only, this t will be given the memory of this struct node. My dynamically, this node structure node's memory will be allocated. Got it? Right, even though it's a pointer, so this will become a node, because once this line is executed, the address part and data part will be allocated for this particular pointer. But I'm not going to allocate this for the head pointer. I should not. That is not a best practice actually. I should not allocate this for the head pointer actually. I think the same thing has been taught to you. So I'll create a head pointer, that's all, of type node. Okay. right? I'm just creating an empty head pointer, but no memory has been allocated. What is the role of a pointer? What does a pointer points actually? What does a pointer points actually? A pointer always points to the address of a variable. It points to an address. Now here, this head pointer, its value should be an address. Whose address it should have? It should point to the, in this sequence, what is the first node? This 1x will be pointed here. The first node's address will be always pointed. Got it? Right? So, now what happens? If I want to, how the print function works? See, I will type head of, or head not equal to null, or head of not, next not equal to null. So, one second, I'm getting stuck up with my screen. My screen is getting stuck up on that. See, what I will do is, while head, this is the head pointer, head not equal to null, this is the condition. If it is not equal to null, then I will print that head of data. Got it? And what I will do, head is equal to head of next. This is the logic I am going to write inside the for loop, correct? So what happens here, right now I will check this head pointer, what is the value? It is not equal to null, no, it is not equal to null, it has some address, okay. Now, what it points, head of data means what? The value in this head is what? 1x, the address of the first node. That first node's data it will be pointing, that will be printed. So, 1 will be printed here. Next, what is the next line? I am changing the head. Head is equal to what? The value of head is equal to what? Head of next. What is the mean by head of next? Head of next is what? 1x. What is the value in head? 1x. 1x of next is what? It will go and check the first node's next value. What is the next, in the next, in the address part of the first node, what is the value? 2x. Now, that will be updated in the head. It will be updated as 2x. Got it? And after this, it will go here. Now, it is checking the head of, now head of next is null, 2x, right? How it is getting skipped to that? Got it? Now, it prints this, it will check this condition, not equal to null, yes. It will print the data. Now again, I am changing this head is equal to head of next. So what is there in head 2? 2x of next is what? The address part of the second node is what? 3x. So that will be updated to the head pointer. Okay, likewise here, it will go here, it will check for this condition, it will print it. And what happens? Address part of 3x is what? 4x. Got it? Again, it will check, it will print, and head is equal to head of next. Okay, what is there? It is null. At this, the head value will become null. So, I am marking it as null. Okay, at the end of this particular node iteration, the head value becomes null. And next iteration, I am just checking head not equal to null. It is equal to null, so I will stop this. So, what happens? Are we moving? Are we jumping from one node to another node? That should not be an assumption. That is for the basic understanding that has been given in your books and all. But the real concept lies here. It is not jumping from one node to another. The reference of next, the value in the head pointer will be changed. Got it? So, head pointer is a pointer which always points to a node. It may be a starting node. So, you should create a head as a node. There are some books, there are some online materials where they have created head as a node, but that is not a good practice at all. You have to make sure that it has to be worked in this way. Got it? This is the best practice of writing this, because always we need to have a best practice of writing a code. You're clear? So any doubts on this? So now can you tell me head is a pointer? Head is a pointer? Now can you tell me head is a pointer? Or a node? Respond me please. The polling, through poll. That's good. So head is a pointer, not a node. You clear? Right? Shall we go for the next level of programs? So I'm not going to touch upon the insertion logic and all this kind of stuff. So we are going to teach you some couple of programs or three programs maximum. Okay, will not take much time. So yes, almost everyone has agreed with this. So this is also an important assumption, because this kind of fundamentals, if you are strong enough, that will be a great thing for you. Got it? You clear or not? Respond me. That's good. Right. So now the program which I'm going to teach you is, see, the materials, all these logics are already available in what you call it as, the logics are already available in many websites. So you, this logic can be replicated in many websites. If anyone have that idea, that understanding to learn on their own, it is well and good. But I'm teaching in common for all. If it is kind of a repetition also, please understand what I'm teaching. So my question is, you have been given a linked list. So let us take this as a linked list. The first question is, find the midpoint. Midpoint of a linked list. So normally, what will be the steps in, if it is an array, what will you do? The length divided by 2, and then that particular index, midpoint value. Find the midpoint value of an array means the array length is already fixed. So you know the length, whereas in linked list, you don't know the length. So what will be your algorithm in linked list? Can you please tell me what will be your algorithm in a linked list? Can anyone type there? Sambhav sir, is there any collaborative typing like shared typing? Can everyone use this whiteboard?
Sir, it is not possible, sir.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, can anyone type it in this chat box? What will be a step to find the midpoint of a linked list? Basic. I'm not getting into the brute force approach. I'm just asking you the basic approach. I'm not talking about the basic approach. So I'm not talking about the advanced approach. I'm just talking about the very, very basic approach for this. Anyone there? I'm expecting some answers. Okay. Yeah, Mithun. Good, good. I appreciate your suggestion. So the Mithun's logic is find the count. So you need to find the number of nodes. So find the count of this, length of this linked list. Count in the sense he's telling about. So finding the length. Of linked list. So how will you find the length? See, in array it is static. Got it? So your length is fixed, you know the length when the array is declared. Whereas in linked list, you don't know. So if you want, you can add more nodes then and there and wherever we want. Now what you are supposed to do is, here, we will be traversing. So as we are going to print, instead of printing in this logic, I just can increment the counter. Okay, fine. Can you able to understand what I am telling now? So you need to find the length of the linked list. So instead of printing, I can have a counter variable that count plus plus. So this count will get the length. So the next time I run this while loop. Okay, while head not equal to null, and I need to count values. I need to run till this count by 2 times, and I will print that. If I reach that particular position, if I reach this count by 2 position, then I have to print that particular node. Here 4 by 2, 0, 1, 2. So this one or this one, this can be considered as a midpoint. Got it? So 4 by 2, the second node will be the middle node here. Yes? Fine. So now what happens? What is the drawback? So this is a brute force approach. See, always don't think, so since you guys, we have started this session earlier this semester, because last 5 years we are not able to start, but we have been starting these kind of sessions this time. So don't worry, we will not stay with data success too long, but data success are very important. So I'll tell you, I'll share you some amazing questions. How many data success questions have been asked? You can go and see in Geeks for Geeks. You can go and see. That's why this is very important. Rather than importance, the logic which we tell you, that can be applied for many other different linked list programs. So this is the fundamental for advanced logics in linked list. So here, what we are supposed to do is, see, the first is, this is a brute force approach. First, I need to traverse the time complexity n times. For example, if the length is 4 times you will traverse. Next, plus 4 by 2 is what, 2. So 6 times you will be traversing. Got it? So separate traversals you need to do. So this is one important drawback here. This is the basic brute force approach. But what they expect in the product companies is, you should not find the length. They will have you an assumption like, please don't find the length. Write the logic to find it. So this one question has been asked. This one, loop detection. I'll tell you the logic, then we will get into the program. Because straight up if we get into the program, you will not be able to understand how it works. See, now here, because last month in one company, I don't remember the company, maybe Sahaj or one product company last month, it came for your seniors. For them, they asked this question, like how to detect a loop in a linked list. Okay, how to detect, check whether the linked list is in a loop. So for that, they asked them to write a logic. Okay, and explain that logic. Got it? So our students have answered because it has been taught to them. So now here, there is brute force. So you find a solution, that's all. You don't understand, you don't know how it impacts your system's performance. So we need to have a better approach. Okay, this is a very basic, actually, this is an easiest solution. Okay, how many of you know the tortoise and rabbit story? Tortoise and rabbit, or hare and tortoise. So hare, this H-A-R-E is also called as rabbit, correct? Right. How many of you know the story? You would have studied in your kindergarten, right? So can anyone switch on your mic? Post a request. Can anyone? Yeah, Prashant, that's okay, fine. Yeah, understood. Yeah, Prashant. Yes, can anyone tell me? I think you got my logic. Can anyone raise a request to Sampath sir so that he can enable your mic? Can you tell me that hare and tortoise story? Can anyone? Can anyone please? Is there anyone? Samad sir, anyone has given the request?
No sir, not yet.
Not yet?
Yes sir.
Okay, Samad sir, you please tell me that hare and tortoise, because I am bored of telling that story. Can you please tell me normal, general, don't take anything technical. Just tell that general story.
Sir, I got some mic problems, sir.
Sir, your voice is very much audible, sir. Don't just bluff as if you are a student.
Okay, sir.
Don't react like a student, sir.
Okay, sir. It was a...
Chitra ma'am, you are there. As students are not opening their mouth, I want some of our faculty to tell the story. Can you please, anyone is there?
Yes, sir. It's Sharmila.
Yeah, ma'am. You tell, ma'am, please. Tell the hare and tortoise kindergarten story. That's enough.
Yes. Do everyone know the tortoise and hare story? Very kindergarten story, right? Yeah, LKG you would have learned, or LKG or UKG. Yes? There will be a hare and a tortoise, and they were conversing. There will be an argument between them whether who's going to move fast or something. And so they will plan for a race. They both will plan for a race. Yes or no? Do you remember? So they will plan for a race. So when they plan for a race, once they start the race in the next day, what does a hare do? It will start run. it will run in a very fast mode. It will run very fast to the end. Meanwhile, the tortoise will walk slowly as it does every day. It will be walking in a very slow manner as it does in every way, every day. And so the hare is so confident about it that it will reach the end very fast than the tortoise. So it will take rest for some time. He thought of taking rest for some time under a tree. While taking rest, this tortoise went to the end and reached the destination.
Yes. So this is the basic story. Thank you, Sharmila ma'am. This is the basic story of hare and tortoise. Correct? Okay, fine. Now, let us consider how rabbit or hare or rabbit goes faster. It will not take one step at a time. Rabbit will not take one step at a time. Right? Rather, it will jump. So, jumping means covering two steps at a time. Whereas tortoise will go slowly. So, one by one, step by step it will go. So, it will jump only one step. It will take one step at a time. Which one? This is tortoise. Now, let us apply this logic here. Got it? Now, let us apply this logic. Let me create a new linked list. This is the logic for this particular program. Got it? This is a new set of linked list. 3, 4, and 5. Okay, now this has been pointing to this. This is how it gets linked here and then here. Now this is the address, this is the node, address and data path, the segregation. 1, next. 2x, 3x, next is 4th node and address will be 5x. So I have not made it wrong. 3 will be pointing to 4x, 2 will be pointing to 3x, 1 will be pointing to 2x. Got it? Then this is the 5th node, 5. And after this, nothing is there. I will be marking it as null. Now here, since we have two animals, rabbit and tortoise, I want to create two pointers. Okay. Two head pointers. So, two head pointers. One head pointer is known as fast and another head pointer is known as slow. Right. So, both the head pointers. So, how will I create? I will just create that scenario here also. This is the head pointer 1 and this is the head pointer 2. Okay. Right. So, this is what you call it as fast and this is what you call it as slow. So, both points to what? 1x. Okay, both points to 1x. Initially, it points to 1x. Got it? So, now let us define the logic for this, both the pointers. So, how the fast pointer moves? Fast pointer equals fast of, next. Slow pointer moves slow of, next. Got it? Now, I am moving the fast pointer. So, how will I change it? How will I do it? I am moving the fast pointer. So, I need to check first the fast pointer moves twice. So, my logic will be why fast pointer immediately there is no nodes in this linked list. It means the fast pointer itself is a null. And I need to check whether the fast pointer of next equal to null. Okay, not equal to null. Not equal to null or only then I can move, right? Only this condition is true. Not equal to null. Got it? Right. Now, initially what? Fast is not equal to null? Yes. And fast of next means what? What is the value here? Fast of next means what? Fast, what address? 1x. Fast address is 1x. 1x of next is what? It is also not equal to null. Okay, because fast pointer has to jump twice. That is why I am checking the current node current pointer's address and the next address of the first pointer's value also should not be equal to null. Got it? So now what happens? The first pointer jumps. Got it? I'm just jumping. So first is equal to first of next. It will come here and it will come here. Got it? Right. And the next line, what happens? Slow pointer does not jump twice. I just made it wrong. Slow pointer jumps only once. So what happens? For the same iteration, the slow pointer also starts here. Got it? Slow pointer will reach here. Right. Now again, the next iteration, again I'm checking. Fast not equal to null. Yes. Now the fast is pointing to this 2x. Now the fast becomes what? 2x. Correct? Correct. It has reached the second node. Got it? Right. 2x is not equal to null. Right? And 2x of next is also not equal to null. Now the fast pointer is what? 2x of next is what? 3x. So, and next of next means what? It will jump from here to here. Got it? And then the slow pointer will move from here to here, one jump at a time. Now again the same iteration, fast not equal to null and fast of next not equal to null. Got it? Right? Understood? Yes or no? Now fast moves, it becomes null and slow pointer will move to the next. Now the pointer gets updated, now the loop gets terminated. Got it? Right. Now what happens? Where is the slow pointer right now? Now where is the slow pointer? After the loop gets iterated, just return slow of the same loop. Got it? Yes or no? Understood or not? Guys, can you able to understand what I'm telling? This, can you able to understand? Can you just draw it? Can you please draw it? Yes, guys, any doubts in this? Can you able to understand? Right? Now, shall we implement this code? Shall we implement the same thing in our code? Yes? So, what are the functions we need to create first of all? So, first, any append function or insert at the beginning. Okay, any insertion. Okay, and display and midpoint logic. So, these are the things we have to write. Now, first step, I'm just creating a struct. Node. Okay, so int data struct node star next. Got it? Right? Now you have to write first step what we are going to create to insert. Let us start with one head pointer. For insertion, let us not get into double pointer. Let us start with one head pointer. Got it? Fine. So, okay. So, node star head equals null, because this is a head pointer. It points to only the starting node, correct? Starting node of your linked list. It should point only to the starting node of your linked list. So I'm just leaving it as empty, not assigning anything. So here I'm not getting the input from the user. I'm just getting the input directly. So struct, I'm going to create multiple nodes star, or I'm going to call a function. Got it? So let us create some functions. So just create one empty node star one. Since these are all not head, I'm just going to create a node. I need to allocate dynamic memory allocation for this. Struct node star malloc size of struct node. Got it? Now head, what is the value of head? Head is a pointer. It points to what? The address of this. Okay, so since it's a pointer, the pointer's address will be given by its directory. So head is pointing to node 1. I mean the value of the head is equal to what? 1x right now. Okay, I write a function. Okay, I write a function void insert at first. Okay, I write a function called as void insert at first. See, the best practice is to give double pointer of head comma, right, head comma the data. So head reference comma int data. So I think even in your arithmetic programs you have been given, you have been taught you using double pointers, because this is the proper way. Why we are going to use double pointer? What is the role of a double pointer? It stores a single pointer address. Now what I am storing here, double pointer means, can anyone tell me, explain this? Double pointer, I am not passing the head pointer, correct? The address of that head pointer has been passed here. Okay, so that is why I am going to use this double pointer, because when I call the function insert at first means address of head, come on, okay, some data. You are clear? Understood? Yes? Where shall I proceed? Shall I proceed or not? Am I audible? Sambhu sir, am I audible?
Yes sir, you are audible sir.
Okay, okay. I am passing some data here. Okay, right? So ampersand of head and some value 5. So I want to insert at the beginning. Now let us write the code for insert at the beginning. So struct, I am creating a new node. Struct node star new underscore node equals what? Struct node. Okay, right, struct node star. So because a new node is not a head pointer, a new node has to be created. So malloc, so because these things has been already done, I'm not getting much into it. Size of got it. Now new node of data is already passed in the parameter. Okay, new node of data is equal to what? The data, right? Now initially the new node's address part, what should be the new node's address part? New underscore nodes address path. What should be the new node's address path? It should point to the first node, where the first node address is stored in the head pointer. Okay, so first initially I am making the new node of mix is equal to null. Got it? Yes. Now I need to check what I need to check. I need to check if the head reference is already null. If the value at okay, if star head ref equal to null, star means what? Dereference. It means the value at that. So in the head pointer, what will be the value? Got it? In the head pointer, what will be the value? So that value is written. So what will be there in the head pointer? What is the value in the head pointer? The first node's address. It is null? No, it is not null. So if it is equal to null, then there is no new node inserted. So this new node will be the head pointer's reference node. For this condition, I am taking yes. Got it? Can you able to understand this? If there is, so if the head pointer is empty, if the head pointer is empty, now the new node which I am creating, that address will be given here. New nodes X will be given here. So that is a line. Else, if the head pointer is already assigned to some other node, what we are supposed to do is, if it is not equal to null, okay. Yes, if the head pointer is not equal to null, then what am I supposed to do? I need to pass what? New node of next is equal to, I think this has been taught by Girisar and others, so just I'm running to this head reference. Okay, right? Now and then I need to point the head reference to new node. I'll tell you the meaning very simple in a fast way. See, see what happens here in the new node. Okay, so already the first node, just see. In a normal scenario, what happens? The head pointer will be there. Okay. So here in our program, what I have done, so I'll just do it again. If it will take 5 or 2 minutes, no, that's all. This is a head pointer and a new node has been created with data 1. Got it? A new node has been created with data 1. And this head pointer points to what? That 1x. Okay, right. Now here in the else part, what I'm doing is, in the else part, what I am doing is new node of next, the new node I have created, right? So in the previous lines I have created a new node, so this is the new node. Got it? So a new node will be created later, which was created using that function. So I am marking its next. Okay, I am marking its next. Got it? So this new node has address part and data part. What is the next? So I should make already this one head pointer is pointing to this. I need to break this link. I need to make this head pointer point to this particular location. So for that only I am using this. What? That a new node of next should point to what? The value of the head ref. So what is happening here is new node of next. See this line. New node of next points to the value of the head pointer. What is there in the value of the head pointer? The value of the head pointer is nothing but 1x. So now here the new node of next value should be 1x. Right? So it has some value. For example, let us have some value in this new node of next. Some 5 or something, anything. So let us take it as 4. Now I have stored the already which node the new node, head pointer is pointing, that's address in the new node. Now I need to break this link. Now what I'm going to do, I need to make this head pointer point to what? The new node, instead of that one node, that new node. So that is the next line. The head ref has been again changed to new node. That's it, right? Now let us get into the logic, like why find midpoint. So how will I find the midpoint? How am I supposed to find the midpoint? So print middle point, midpoint. Got it? So void midpoint. Okay, see here, struct node. Star head ref. Okay. So how many pointers I'm going to create? So struct node past struct node star. So these are the two pointers I'm creating. Okay, these two pointers, what it should point? The starting node. Who's having the starting node's address? The head node. Okay, so it points to what? The head ref. It points to the head ref. The value head ref is the thing that the starting node's address. Both points to the head node. Okay, right. Now I'm running this function. Y fast not equal to null and fast of next of next not equal to null. Okay, so if this condition is true, I need to increase the fast is equal to what? Fast of next slow is equal to what? Slow of next of next. So finally, what am I supposed to do? Finally, I need to print the middle data, right? So printf. So where the middle data will be stored? The slow pointer. Printf what? Slash in the midpoint data is percentage d comma, right? So slow of data. At that point, when the fast pointer moves to the end, the slow pointer will be in one particular location. That will be a midpoint. So I'm just, instead of having this, I'm just running a for loop. So in scanf percentage d ampersand get for I equals 0 index less than n index plus plus. Okay, so n times I'm going to insert a new node. First node alone, I have just pointed here. The first node data I'm just adding. The initial node alone I'm just adding 1. Yes, so just I'm creating some manual notes. One of next equal to 2. So this is another node I'm going to create. So for that, for this basic understanding, I'm just creating all these things. Got it? The head is equal to. So I'll create another node manually. Data equal to 2 of next is null. Okay, right now what I'm doing, head pointer is pointed to 1. Okay, so 1 is pointed to 2 is pointed to null. Now after this, these gets executed, this for loop gets executed, number of nodes. So here what happens, this loop gets run every time a new node will be inserted at the first, at the beginning. So this logic is used to insert at the first. Okay, right? So I'm just calling this number of nodes to enter at the beginning. Okay, right. Now, as I'm using my malloc hash include std lib dot h. Okay, right. Now let me run this one. Okay, I want to call that middle data function. So, midpoint function has to be called. Okay, so node has entered number of nodes to create. I have manually created 3 nodes. From the user, I'm going to create more nodes. Okay, so I don't have to do it. Let me manually call that function twice. We don't have much time, that's why insert it first. Debug number, I don't have time right now. Let me see another program. 6. Manually calling this multiple times. I mustn't have right. 7. The midpoint data is 1. How? How come the midpoint data is 1? How come, pa? How? It's if I'm adding another node. Yes, you understood how it works? Clear or not? Just any doubts on this, guys? Any doubts on this logic? If you have any doubts, you can let me know. I think I've made some mistakes. Slow is equal to. Okay, sorry, slow off next. Yes, fine. Yes, the midpoint data is 6. If I'm adding another node, yes, what I did is, like, I'm sorry, I've done slow's pointer has been jumped twice, so it has to be jumped only once. That is why if I add new node, then it has been skipped out of that loop. So there is no such node, that is why the core segment default has been done. Got it? You clear? You clear this logic? Was it easy or not? Yes, if I am adding another node, for example. Clear? Right? Fine. Now, how many of you don't understand this logic? I think everyone have understood this logic, right? Yes or no? Yes, fine. Now let us get into the next program. I want some of you to try that program and share that program to me. Okay, I think that is also available in your EdMatrix. Let me check the program if it is available or not. Okay, fine. Now, the next logic is how to find a loop, loop detection, how to find a loop. How to detect a loop? What is meant by loop? See, you have a set of nodes. Okay, you have a set of nodes like this, and the linked list must have one node at least pointing to the null. Here's what happens: if one node is not pointing to the null, there will not be a proper termination. For example, and 5, if it is a proper linked list, the fifth node will point to null. But rather, if I want to check whether there is a loop, if the fifth node again points to 3x, means what? The loop will be like this. Third node suppress. Yes? Yes or no? Right now, again, it will, the third will point to 4, 4 will point to 5, and 5 will again point to 3. This loop will not run. So I need to check whether there is a loop or not. How will I check? How will I detect a loop in a linked list? This logic, because I try to cover more problems, because it is not a good idea to cover more next level problems in a linked list in the same session. So we will stop with this loop detection, and next class in between we will be teaching you intersection point. You can also think on your own, but intersection point is slightly different with this two pointer concept. Whereas how will you find a loop? How will you find a loop? Yes? Shall I tell you? Shall I tell you or not? Or you can think on your own? Are you able to understand and understand the question? Can you think on your own, or else using nested looping? Okay, fine. Again, you can use that fast and slow pointer. This is called as Lloyd's loop detection algorithm. Okay, it uses what? Two pointers. See, for certain problems, we have some fixed solution. That fixed solution is given by an algorithm, not a brute force thing, some algorithm. So this is called as Lloyd's loop detection algorithm. So where you will be having two pointers, slow and fast. Okay, so what you're going to do is, both slow and fast pointer points to the head pointer will be there in between. The head pointer will point to this starting node. What it? Right? The slower point, fast pointer will point to this head pointer. This, that both head pointer initially will start to the first node. So as we did, we will, so let me mark the slow here for better understanding, and fast here. So fast will jump twice. So for the first iteration, fast will come here. Slow will be here. For every iteration, I need to check the value of fast and the address of fast and slow. So for every jump, for every iteration, fast will jump twice and slow will jump only once. So after first iteration, I'm checking where the slow pointer points 1x, whereas fast pointer points to 2x. Okay, both are not equal. Likewise, again the next iteration, I need to check for that fast pointer null condition also, as we did in the last program. Okay, again the slow pointer comes here and fast pointer from here it goes to this. Again the slow pointer comes here, the next iteration the fast pointer again here and then from here it comes here. Got it? And this point I am checking slow and fast pointer, which address it is pointing? 3. x equal to 3x. So for every iteration I move fast pointer twice and slow pointer once. I will check the address of fast pointer and slow pointer. Both points to the same address means then there is a loop. That's all. I need to break. I need to find that there is a loop. You clear? Yes or no? Understand this logic? Yes? Yes or no? Yes or no, pa? Yes or no? Guys, please let me know, yes or no? This is my input scenario. Okay, I write and insert at first function itself. Okay, so this is I am simulating head of next of next of next. So head, it points to the next is 2, 1, 2, 3, and then again this third node again points to the head. Again it's a loop, right? Head is what? Again it points to the same node. It is not pointing to the end point. So this I am simulating this. So you cannot write it on your own because this is the simulation for this loop. Input simulation for loop detection. Got it? Now you can write a function. So how to detect a loop? I need to return whether it is true or false. That's all. The loop is there or not. That's all I'm going to do. Okay. So write a function. So bool. So bool is a new data type in C. Correct? Bool is a new data type. Hash include. Bool dot h. It belongs to the header file. Bool. It returns true or false, not zeros and ones. True or false. So bool detect loop. So this is my going to my function. Got it? Yes. So struct node star head reference. Okay, I'm creating two pointers. So struct node star head star fast equals what? Head headref, but because the headref stores the first node's address, slow headref. Got it? Right. Now I'm going to run this condition while slow pointer is not equal to, because slow pointer every time I need to check while slow not equal to null. Because fast pointer goes on, because since it's a what do you call it, I cannot stop till the fast pointer. Okay, I have to, every time I need to check the slow pointer address value also, not the value, where it points, which node it points. So that's why I'm checking this condition based on the slow pointer. Slow not equal to null. So slow is equal to of next. Fast is equal to fast of next of next. Got it? Yes. Now every time I need to check that extra step, if slow equals fast, the address, the values in the slow one address, so slow one, the pointer to pointer is compact, it means the address will be compact. Return. Okay, if that is not, then the whole function will return false. Understood? Yes or no? Yes. Now in my main function, I just call that function printf percentage. Printf what? I just call that function. Okay. Detect loop head. Okay. Right. If this is a boolean function, right? If it is true, then I need to call the printf loop detected else printf no loop. Yes, got it. That's it. So loop was detected because I have given the scenario. Got it? So your thinking has to be like this. Understood? You clear or not, guys? We will have many more advanced sessions hereafter. So most probably for CB1, CB2, we'll be combining and taking. Okay. In future, if there is any important topics to be taught in the data structures kind of thing, so we'll be taking a combined session. Got it? Respond me. Okay. So understood. Concept stop for the session. Give me yes or no. No. Yes, give me a polling. Yes. So that midpoint function is present in your EdMatrix. The program is present in EdMatrix. I will share that in the chat box also, that link. You can solve that. If any doubts, you can post it in the discussion forum. Utilization of discussion forum is also equally important. Provide a polling results. Make it fast. Okay, so that's it. I'd like to thank you all for being staying patient with the session. So we'll meet in many more sessions in the future. Afternoon, we have a skill rack assessment, and also before that, skill rack assessment, make them into the session, ask them to join to the session, ask them to solve that in EdMatrix. You create a go-to meeting, CB1, CB2 separate go-to meeting, ask them and have a doubt clarification on your own. Okay, ma'am? Yes, sir. Thank you, Sambat. Thank you, Sambat, sir.
You're welcome, sir.
Yeah, thank you.